Okay, all of my tomatoes have the Septoria black leaf spot. Black spot, sorry. Leaf black spot, oh, whatever, disease. It is early in the season. I'm just flowering and tomatoes are just starting, and they're on all of my tomato plants. Those were the grape tomatoes. These are the Romas. They're all down there. And this is halfway up the plant. This is high up off, high on the plant, and I'm not happy at all. These are the beefsteak tomatoes. It just seems to have gotten very, very early in the season on my plants. I mean, it's only the beginning of July, and they're really diseased. And what had happened was we've had about 2 weeks of rain. I mean, lots of rain. Lots of rain, lots of humidity. And yeah. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut down as many leaves as I can. And then tonight I'm going to spray with sulphur, but then I was reading, don't just spray with sulphur, get copper on the plants. So before I spray them, I'm going to go out and get some sulphur if I can. I mean some copper. So I mix them together. Otherwise it's just wasting time if I have to do it twice. So that's what I'm going to do. So lots and lots of leaves taken off these plants. Cleaned it out as much as possible. There are still some spots on some of the plants. I mean, we can't take every leaf that has a spot on it off, because then we'd have no plant left. Look at that. But I will copper, I will sulfur, we prayed. Lord, bless the land, bless the plants, and keep the disease away. Today's July 7th, 2015. It's a Monday, and it's quiet, so I think I can actually make a video without someone's lawnmower or someone's chainsaw or something going off. So I'm just going to do an update. I left the spinach here just to bolt and see what it does. So just leaving that in the bowl. I have my containers of peppermint. They're all growing up. Which is great, because I can't wait to make peppermint tea this fall. There's nothing in that one. I did plant echinacea in here. It looks like something's eating them. Yeah. I think these broadleaf ones are the echinacea. All the lavender plants here, the 12 lavender plants, seem to have taken nicely to the ground. This tomato plant, besides having sawdust all over it, let's see if we can get it to focus. I'm in the sun here, so it has, I don't know how much we can see, black spots all over it. The whole thing is speckled, it seems. Except for the top leaves, this doesn't look too bad. But I'm disappointed. I don't know what this is, if it's some kind of a rust. That to me just looks like black spot. I'm not sure with this particular plant because nothing's yellowed yet. Yeah. But all the lower leaves, look, they're just covered. Oh, that's shaking in the wind. Let's see if I can get a picture here. Okay. Cilantro is bolting. I don't know if it's supposed to be like this. Like, it hasn't flowered yet, and there's no blooms or blossoms. It's just leaf, leaf, leaf. So I'm letting that stay. If I start seeing some kind of flowers coming out, I am going to cut it down right away. And then the basil is getting larger. Okay, another peppermint. This is Roma tomato. And even this one here has spots on the leaves. Sage. My sage is wilting, and I think it's because it's just gotten too much water. I don't think sage likes to have its feet wet constantly. Hopefully it'll dry out. Now, we've had so much rain, like 2 weeks of rain, and this area just hasn't even been able to dry out like until now, and it's starting to get dry. This is usually the driest area, and that's why I put it here. So, it's supposed to rain tomorrow, but hopefully, I don't know what I'm going to do with this. I might dig it up and put it somewhere else if it just continues to stay wet all summer. Hopefully it'll be alright. Okay, oregano, rosemary, the echinaceas. I put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 here. I need to remember that for next year. The sunflowers are getting large. The lemon balm. Let's get this out of here. I should actually probably trim this now. The peony flowers are done. This lemon balm is spreading out nicely. These are the chamomile. Oh, look, I got 3 little ones there and 4 here. Well, at least they're starting. These weeds out of here. I put another echinacea here. I don't know how well this is going to do. This is really dry, and all we have here are hostas. The soil is just clay. It's just horrible clay. I added a little bit of peat moss in there when I planted them. So then I put 4 over here. We cut down this bush. This is a big, huge bush. We just cut that down a bit. Hopefully this will get some sun this year and it'll grow up. I don't know, it seems to be doing pretty good. Like, look at the centers here. There's new leaves coming, and this is one of the driest, most desolate areas of my property. Kale in the bucket. It's doing nicely. Saw the white moths here earlier, and I think I'm gonna cover it in tulle, something like that, or organza, some kind of fabric. And cucumbers. Now, these ones here are pickling cucumbers. See, that's the kind of butterfly you don't want in your garden, because they lay eggs. Pickling cucumbers are here, and they were from seed, but they're doing really well. They're just starting to vine out nicely. I think I'm not sure if it's a straight 8 or the English longs, but anyways, straight 8 or English longs are along these two lines here. 1, 2, 3. There are some little cucumbers starting on those. And same with the zucchinis. These plants here are actually caught up with the one that I planted about a month before them. So because of the heat and the sun in summertime, these are sunflowers, they're all catching up, and they've got zucchinis starting on them also. I just put some calcium magnesium on these, along with the zucchini and my tomatoes today, because I was starting to get this on my cucumbers. I'm not sure what it is, but you see, it's not good. So I don't know if that's a black spot, Septoria, or if it was some kind of a blight. But in order for your plants to be healthy, you've got to give them proper nutrients. So I gave them some more calcium and magnesium today to help them fight. And look at those little zucchinis, they're doing really well. Doesn't look like I got any blossom end rot, so I'm happy about that. So far, so good. This morning, you know, I still have some leaves that have little spots on them. Today I'm going to get copper, and I will put copper and sulfur on these plants. But like I said, I put the magnesium and the calcium in here first, so that, look at that, isn't that nice? What a nice bunch right there of tomatoes. And there are a couple, three clusters that I see so far. Tomatoes, lots more growing. I don't want to lose these plants. Beans are doing good. They're growing and flowering. They got buds on them. And this one's another one that we cleaned out all the leaves. And there is a cluster of tomatoes in here also. Well, I can't see what the camera sees right now, but oh, they're there. Big sunflower. Aroma tomatoes. Still have a lot of leaves that have spots, but there's really not much I can do. We got all the major leaves off of there. But I mean, I've got tomatoes on here. Look at this, let me find them. See the Roma tomatoes? I've got lots of tomatoes in here, and I don't want to lose these plants. So I'm not happy that disease has, you know. Let me take another picture of that. Yeah. Nice. There's tomatoes on all these plants. So these are all the Roma tomatoes. And then my beefsteaks. Oh. Cleaned out all the bottom. These beefsteak plants, I tell ya, you know, it's like the bigger the fruit, the bigger the plant, obviously. But if you can see the stem on that beefsteak plant, that is, it's such a thick, amazing stem in there. And I've got beefsteak tomatoes starting in here. Third poop on there, I'm gonna take that off. We lost a lot of branches too, so I'm not sure. I had to take, even some blossoms off of here. Hopefully these will continue. I don't know how much support this branch is gonna get. I don't know. This little guy here grew down and he seems to be, see how he bent here? See all that? So this will support this branch. That's what they do, that's what the plant does. So I've got 4 of my beefsteaks. And they got their vitamins this morning. Lots of blossoms. I don't want to lose these plants. Let me see if I can get a, give you an idea. Look how huge these stems are. Of this tomato plant. Strong. Very strong plant. Okay, on to the peppers. They got the calcium, magnesium. Also, I don't show any signs of blossom end rot, and I am happy with that. Prevention is worth a pound of cure. My red peppers, which were smaller plants, they were a month behind my orange ones. They actually have some peppers on them that are larger than the orange peppers. I'm going to show you this. Look at this. Look at that beautiful green pepper. Those are the red ones, the ones that turn red. And this is July 7th. There's lots of peppers in here. Let me take a picture of this one. Get my pot out of the way. There's beans growing in here. Over here, we've got parsley. And it did fill out more. Those seeds did fill out. My rosemary, I don't see any rosemary in here. I've got some in the house. I don't know if I'm going to put it out here or not. Here's the cilantro again. And the thyme. Beets. I haven't planted beets before, so I'm kind of, I think these is neat. They're coming up out of the surface, so I know they're growing there. I don't know why there's spots on these. I don't know what this is. But, yeah. Hopefully it's just bugs eating them or something, not a disease. And the kale, I'm going to cover my kale too. There's only so much chicken wire can do. Keeping the rabbits out and not a lot of bugs though, because they are eating them, so it doesn't keep a lot of the bugs out. And there's all the dill. Dill's doing fabulous. Okay, so that's the update. Tonight in the evening, I'm going to spray with a copper and sulfur. I'm going to spray my tomatoes, my cucumbers, my zucchini, and no, I don't have to spray my peppers. I think what I'll just do is maybe, I don't know, I don't think my peppers really need spraying. Maybe some neem seed oil, but maybe. We'll see. It's supposed to rain tomorrow too, so I just need the fungicide on these things in a natural way. You know, plants need their vitamins. Just like people do. So if you don't have your vitamins, you're more prone to get sick. So if you give your plants the vitamins they need, then apparently they're supposed to be healthy enough to help fight the diseases that come against them. So that's what I'm going to try to do for these plants. Thanks for watching.